go up to the sticker, and you hit next.
Oh, okay.
And then you go up to your stickers. And there's the one that says link right down there.
I'm trying to call it podcast soon.
Tune in on Twitch, and then you hit it.
Man, I'm going to edit this. I'm just going to get rid of this soon.
Now.
Story. There we go.
Mention questions.
You see the link right there?
Yeah, there you go.
And then you just type in your link.
Piss. Aw, shit. Charlie, will you text me the link? Because I am in my Instagram, like, I'm creating it right now. I don't want to go back and delete that shit. 360-701-8017. Holy shit. 360-841? 360. Oh, shit. You just made me forget my phone number. Give me a second.
701-8017.
Okay. Sent it to you. Yo, in the headphones, I got some thunder and lightning type shit going on. It's crazy.
Yeah, they'll hear it. I mean, with that, you'll be able to hear pretty much everything that goes on up there.
That's so tight. I fuck with that.
That'll be okay.
Nah, I kind of like it right here. Sounds like it's raining real hard outside.
Alright, sticker.
Okay. She's an outdoor podcast.
But you said there's a link sticker?
Yeah. Man. Yo, what's up, young Dylan?
What's up? How's the pod?
About to go live.
Gonna go live? You haven't
gone
live yet?
Nah, we're about to go live right now. I'll send you the link, though.
Like, you're calling while he's on live.
You're on the pod.
Hey, welcome in, young Dylan.
Hey, how's it going, bro? Are you coming over or fucking not, bro? Come on, man, we're relying on you right now.
I'm doing business.
Personally, RIP.
To who? Young Dylan?
To whatever business needed doing.
Okay, then we're going to go to... They have Twitch stories now. You got to add to your Twitch story.
Hey, what color should I do for my Twitch Instagram create mode?
What color should you do?
Rainbow.
Yeah, rainbow.
Rainbow.
Black. Orange. Pink.
Probably gay. Purple rainbow. And pink.
Gay rainbow.
That's the one.
Three ejectives. Draymond Green puts Rudy Gobert in headlock. I'll put that one right after.
I thought it would have been Dwight Howard giving head to Rudy Gobert.
Dwight Howard's not in the NBA anymore.
Because of the...
Nah, because... I don't know.
Like, he retired already.
Sorry, hold on. I'm posting everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I'm posting all over. Posting.
Liquid death. Shout out Sadie's sister. Liquid death.
With the fat ass, bro.
Nah.
With the culo mojado, way.
Okay. We are live. We're rolling.
We're live. Live.
Horned up and live.
We got probably no viewers so far.
Really?
They'll come.
They will come.
How long have we been live?
I will finger blast them and they will come.
It's been about like 3 minutes.
3 minutes?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
So we're live?
Dude.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Hey, you can look. They can hear us too, by the way.
I'm talking about, talking about Hard Dig Warriors today. Merch coming soon.
Yeah.
Keep your dicks hard. Don't call that doctor. It's only been 4.5 hours. Keep edging.
Keep edging. That's crazy. Keep gooning. Big gooners up here.
We got audio. I like that.
We love penis. We love audio.
I'm rocking with that.
Yo, so, you with that?
I don't know.
God damn.
What are we going to start with? What's,
First thing, we'll just throw it over. I'll introduce Dave again. Introduce yourself, and you can talk about whatever you want. And then
sounds good.
We'll just get it rolling from there.
You got any glasses in this joint?
No, I don't think so.
All right. Well, RIP Tony. He couldn't make it today. But Dave is here in the studio. Hi, everyone. My name's Dave. I'm a drug addict and alcoholic. I've been clean for a couple years now. We love big booties. We love big memes. We love making you sandwiches. If you want to ask any more, it's going to cost you. Pass the mic to my boy Ryley. Ryley, would you like to introduce yourself?
I'd love to. Young Ryley Tucker.
We're doing this for real now, sorry.
We're doing this for real. This shit is faux real.
I'm gonna play the theme song.
On four now.
Oh, shit. The Charlie Hickmont Pod, we are drowning in content.
It's true.
So true.
Y'all ain't ready. I'm about to push you under with that shit.
Gotta hold you down. For no reason.
Hold you down?
It's tragic. New paddock.
Paddock on my wrist.
But yeah, they're absolutely right. Here we are. This is now officially, I guess, episode 5 or 4, depending
episode
on.
Episode 4 or 5, for y'all keeping count.
Whatever.
Y'all keeping score as.
Of drowning in content. Extremely online podcast. Yes, it's a podcast dedicated to exploring those weird little corners of the internet, our own little personal corners, and sharing them with. And we've got not one, but two amazing special guests with us today. With the return of Dave Morehead, who now is like a kind of like a semi-permanent guest host, rotating guest host. I don't know.
Don't call it a comeback.
Yeah, what's up with that?
We just got
and,
here.
and Ryley. So please, guys. I mean, Dave, you already did, but if you want to go through again and tell everybody who you are and where to find you.
I mean, I am just him, local niche micro celebrity guest host of the Drowning in Content. Hide your wives, hide your kids. We will drown your stepfathers. We're here to show you some fucking memes and some good shit. And if you can't handle that, get the fuck up out the kitchen.
Awesome.
Ryley,
that's
please.
That's the man right there. Please. Young Ryley, Ryley MF Tucker, a.k.a. Thought Pilgrim on the gram. Niche internet micro celebrity, give what you take. I don't know. I'm just
MF
me.
Stand for Mofongo.
Mofongo, Mofongo.
Oh shit! Oh shit!
That shit's crazy. Yeah, not much to say about me, but
But plenty to say about Surf Rock.
Police Academy, Steve Gutenberg. You!
Okay, I went to Hebrew school.
That's why I hate going to TikTok for memes, because it's just like autoplays. I'm like, no,
really?
Quiet, please.
You don't fuck with the TikTok memes?
I do a little bit, and I do want to talk about some of them a little bit today, but we'll get to there when we get to there. But yeah, so this is as I already described, this is kind of a podcast where like people who have been extremely online, will be, and continue to be just scrolling on your phone. If you're that person, you know you are. I feel like, and people who may not have all those things, you know, it's the meme sharing podcast, I guess. I don't know. So Ryley, like, where do you like? Can you describe? Could you talk about your? You're younger than Dave and I. Not to call you out, but
significantly. I feel like you know. I mean
that's fair. Yeah.
Fucking. I mean, Dave, you're 29, so that's 7 years. It doesn't seem like a significant amount, but I mean, like, in terms of like the internet standpoint, I feel like 7 years is really, really a lot. Like those Gen Z memes, like the shit, like people my age are coming out with now or have been coming out with, like, for a while are fucking off the wall. Like, it's like, you know, like, some people really, really don't get it. And, like, sometimes I don't even fucking get it. And that's part of the magic.
Yeah.
Like, part of the magic is, like, not understanding it and just, like, yo, this shit's funny. This shit is, like, you know, like, I don't, like, you don't have to get it.
Yeah.
Like, it's just fucking stupid, you know? Like, it's just, it's all there for, like, a reaction or a laugh or, like, whatever. Like, it's just, I don't know, just wild. Just, like, out of pocket. Just fucking just stupid, stupid shit. Like, just made up, like, whatever. Like, people will come out here, like, I don't know. Like, I'm gonna be honest. Like, one of my favorite memes of all time is, y'all ever heard of Dat Boy?
Yeah.
On Dat Boy. Here comes Dat Boy. Hey, yo, pull that up. Pull that boy up.
Yeah, boy.
I don't know. Just, like, simple shit like that has, like, always gotten to me. Just, like, oh, shit. Here comes that boy.
Oh, shit. What up?
Like.
Here comes that bullshit water. Here comes that bullshit water.
I don't know. I just fuck with it. The simplicity. This was, like, probably when I was, like, a freshman, sophomore in high school. I'm 22 now, but something that just really, really struck with me, like, not even this one in general, just, like, I don't know, like you said, you've known about Dat Boy. There's, like, a lot of variations of this shit. There's so many, like, so much crazy shit you could go towards with this, like,
where's
Dat Boy Hillary?
This one... Sorry, the biggest shitpost we had back in my day was fucking MLG edits.
I have never seen this shit before.
Who uses a stunt double for that, too?
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely not Hillary. But
that is wild. Yeah, that is fucking insane.
Yeah, it was a whole like thing about she did the Pokemon Go to the polls.
Was this when she was chilling in Cedar Rapids or what?
Yeah, just chilling in Cedar Rapids.
Like, she just
and I mean, it's very stereotypical, obviously, to say that.
Yeah.
Hillary Clinton is very old and out of touch and should not be using these kind of memes. But, yeah. Or, you know, she was trying to engage the youth. And obviously she didn't. I mean, she...
She really need to hop on what Nancy Pelosi did with them fucking beach pigs.
I don't know. It's, like, weird. It's, like, it's gotten to the point where I almost feel out of touch with the memes recently. And, like, I'm like, am I getting old? Like, some of the shit is fucking insane out there. Like, dude, I don't mean to be like, some of that shit is absolutely fucking crazy. Like, just like, it's just throwing like multiple, like, just like all these things together, like throwing more and more memes together where it's like, just like taking shit posting to a whole new level.
Oh yeah. Dave and I talked about this at length in the last episode, but
dude,
yeah, we can read that up again. It is.
It's crazy.
It's supposing on a new level is.
Wait, where the fuck is it?
What is phantom tax? What is autism? What is Riz?
Do you know what phantom tax is?
I do.
Are you well-versed in the phantom tax?
I mean, since last episode, I am aware of the phantom. Because I've been around Twitch,
Whoa, did you just say phantom tax?
I just want to be phantom.
F-A-N-U-M.
But, like, shit like this.
My fellow Sigmas, our nation is in Ohio right now. Israel Gaia is rizzed up by Palestinians demanding a phantom tax of a blood. And they're giving the American people criminal offensive side eye. The Affordable Goon Act grants every young adult, male. Fully fleshed out with the goon cave.
Shit like that.
Right. I mean, if we can get a goon cave,
Yeah. Where's my government sanctioned?
Dave, did you by chance send him the the Diary of a Wimpy Kid one?
The don't Ohio me no more.
Yeah, that shit.
Don't even Riz me.
On that note, we could rock that. That could be crazy. We could pull that bitch up.
We're still scrolling through.
R.I.P. Fulcrum, by the way.
Yeah, Fulcrum. What happened to Fulcrum?
Wait, is he
got hit by a car, dude?
Wait, what the fuck?
Fulcrum got hit by a car.
You know about Fulcrum?
Yeah.
You fuck with Fulcrum?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Faded in the hole. Yo, Yodi gang. Can we hit the electronic device in here? Is that allowed?
Yeah, that should be fine.
Can I take the Benjamin to Blinkerton City?
That one doesn't.
Fulcrum reacts to fatal carcass. Oh, it has an accident.
Fulcrum has an accident in the store. That's what it was.
You sure that's not him shitting his pants at the Lowe's?
Dude, Fulcrum makes music too.
If he shit his pants at the Lowe's, that might be the one.
It's fucking
Fulcrum car accident? Is this the thing?
But he fucking had some pussy somewhere.
Okay, well, I can't.
Hey, yo!
What the fuck is that?
It'd be real. Is you gonna fuck the Brazilian fucking, is that Brazilian or Mexican angel?
It was the Mexican Congress.
Angel alien, my bad. Mexican, you fucking the Mexican alien, flesh Lucy?
You know what, I think I'm good. I said that at the time.
You ain't going.
Oh, and so Dave, you were showing me these last time, so Tyler's been sending me these
base
too.
Retard gang? Fucking love base retard gang. BRG time travel. Hyperstition stition. BRG love bug. Base retard gang. There's probably a couple more pages, but these fools are doing it right. They're shit posting in a fucking network. And all those views are also triggering algorithms to their other pages of similar fucking builds. And then they're still getting hits. So they're fucking like 5x in their fucking shit.
I would argue base retard gang is a drain coded.
I think BRG is big time drain core. It's big time Candyman core. It's big time old school filthy prank slash neo plum core.
Yeah, plum core, yeah.
BRG is like on the level. Like they're,
all right.
I refuse to believe that these are actually the Chinese women.
Oh no, for sure.
Who are filming themselves and adding layers and then crazy
for sure.
American anti-propaganda.
Yeah.
But sure. I would believe in a fucking heartbeat that there's just some cats out there like, yo, let's download some Chinese TikTok. Let's fucking put some weird shit on there and let's fucking.
Okay, I've gone back too far.
Throw some overlays.
You've gone too far.
Too far into the memes, for sure.
Spank it.
You tried so hard.
He was.
Gone so far. Fuck the Mexican alien fleshlight, and it didn't even matter.
The end, man.
Damn it! I'm just trying to find the really deep fried AI ones. I was showing.
Yo, I actually hang on.
Here we
totally
go.
Yo, what was that one with I show speed and the AI?
This one's fucking hilarious. Hold on.
The Tale of Two Streams.
Free you! Free your mama!
Alright, Charlie, I'm gonna start sending some your way. I got some, it's not quite the deep fried. I went to look for a specific deep fried.
Free Palestine, bitch! Okay, so you sent an attachment? I see it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's fucking loud as shit, sorry.
Oh no.
He's on to something.
What?
What the car doing?
Oh, we're floating away.
What the sponge doing? Yo, not the.
Damn it. Okay.
Don't read my DMs, people.
Sorry.
You're not allowed. Yo, is that Hamoud?
Where at?
Down at the bottom?
This?
The Ice Spice?
Young Hamoud.
This? Right here?
Yeah, what is that?
We already watched that one. We can watch it again.
You know, the craziest part to me is like, this is an actual fucking. This is like a very big folk song in their culture. This isn't like some deep cut somebody just found. This is like Tune Knock Tune Knock.
Oh, yeah. Tune Knock Tune Knock Tune. What a banger. You know that guy? You know that guy? Like, everybody's complaining because he, like, all his videos, he just had hot women. They're like, oh, your videos are only popular because you have hot women. So yeah. That whole video is just him just to fuck with people. He's just like, no hot women, it's just me.
Four different gypsies. Yeah. And that shit's fucking culture forever. Gypsies, gins.
I've lost all the memes. Now this is no good.
You lost them all.
I mean, obviously there's memes here. This this guy, my friend Tyler. He sends me these because he's like
never goon.
Oh, here's another. Here's another one of these.
That's real.
Period.
Yeah, this is just base retard gang. This is real. Like, there's like I feel like there's like this like aware like fake aware type like side of Instagram where it's like an obvious like you know like it's shit posting but it's also like they're like kind of like feeding into like the Instagram marketing standpoint of it like the you know like just like throwing out that information out there like
yeah
I don't know like but then there's like the
like it still has to be engaging as like an Instagram reel or you know for people to watch it but it's I see what you're saying
but then there's like the other side where it's like fucking like the deep parts of Instagram like that shit I sent you earlier like you literally just messaged me and just said what the fuck
it's just
pull that shit up
it's just like why does this exist why do they do this
can they see this on here
Corn Starch.
Okay yeah
Hardee's
ran across this this young woman on a on
they just start dropping vibes.
So like are you will you roll through the page? Can you go through their account real quick?
So she's eating cornstarch.
Yeah, so I found this this woman on Instagram via the Instagram Reels. Sells cornstarch, sells flavored cornstarch.
What?
So I don't know if this really qualifies as memes or shitposting.
Flavors it with like Jell-O pudding pack fucking flavor.
Like fucking insane shit. Like.
So I don't press none of my rocks. Gene cornstarch, bro.
Like, see, that's like the whole thing, like.
As a cook, like, we've had cornstarch on our fingers.
Yeah, it feels...
If we're really lucky, we've had it in our mouths.
We're really lucky.
What makes you want our balls. Flavor fucking
like,
cornstarch?
Hey, pull up that one, the balls, restocking period. Shelves one.
My restocking shelves. Dies.
Booty, balls, back, bird, like, bottom.
Like, I don't, like, God I don't damn. Know if this is, like...
this She's is got a... kilos of cornstarch.
And this shit's flavored.
You know, you can just buy it at the store, right? Like a lot of
it. She bakes it. She's got different consistencies. Oh my she God. Does she does monthly drops. Apparently, I've done a deep dive on this shit. She's got flavors. She's got consistencies.
Okay.
You want the crunchy stuff? You want the powdery stuff?
Miss Cornstarch, Mrs. Cornstarch Hardee's. All right. Chunkalicious fire.
Oh, the fucking noise.
It's like walking on fucking fresh powdered snow. Oh my God,
this is ridiculous.
What the fuck?
Okay, well, speaking of corn and ridiculous foods, I kind of want to rip this now because like. We got to do it, and then we still got to do it.
Corn foods.
Yeah, we have some ridiculous corn foods. So I'm going to pull up this Twitter here, and we'll watch this.
Don Julio got the bitch wasted.
Don Julio got the bitch wasted with a goddamn fucking Cocoa Pebbles, bro.
Got to have a well-balanced breakfast.
Do we have that, though? We got that on deck?
We don't have Don Julio and Cocoa Pebbles, but we have Cocoa Krispies. And we got tequila, so I feel like we're close enough, you know.
We got Bailey.
We got a few things. We got some options.
So yeah, we're gonna hit this. Yeah.
For all y'all who don't know, we got some shit prepared for y'all.
Yeah, this is how you make the content, pebbles, you know. Yeah. This is how you make the content.
Dump this in the Cocoa Pebbles right now.
So I want to see if I don't think pebbles, anybody. Man. I don't think anybody. I got one. I got 30 views on it. I did post on Twitter to see if anybody had any ideas. What I did hear from talking about it in a couple Twitch chats this morning, one guy said Bailey's and Lucky Charms, you know, classic Irish mix.
Bailey's and Cocoa Pebbles where you play.
See, that looks good. And that's what Chris said he wanted.
We'll start with the good, and then we'll go to the worst.
If
Chris Wait, you said you want me to throw the Grand Marnier and the Cocoa Pebbles?
Grand Marnier and the Cocoa Pebble cup.
What the fuck?
Charlie, you want to...
Oh, yeah.
Let's going crazy with that bitch?
I'll record this, and then I'll chop that up and throw it on the thing. I mean, we about a foot.
I'm spooked. Play out,
man. Yeah, man, we pulled up.
Check me out, though. Hey, while we're pouring these bitches up, can we get some Joey in the background?
Some Joey
in the background? Yeah, you want to throw the
Fiat by Joey, Joeyy.
Why does it smell pretty good?
It smells pretty good. Okay, all right, let's see.
I'll be brave.
Where's the face? The face. Oh no.
Yo, you're not whiffed at.
I love that.
Oh, okay, hold on. For music, though, I did want to bring up, because I saw something, and we can just react to this real quick.
Yeah.
Was it My Agenda?
I thought you guys might appreciate this, if you haven't seen Dorian Electra yet.
Dorian Electra?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
They're on tour right now.
Dorian Electra is sick as fuck. Actually got...
I just saw this video the other day. I'm like, holy fuck.
Charlie, you tried this yet?
No. I'll get it.
It's honestly pretty good.
Hold on, let me get my reaction shot on here.
It's... Is there any way you could turn this up in the headphones?
Oh. It's not... It's not inedible, like it. Oh.
No, that's actually not too bad.
I really like that one.
That doesn't make me worry.
Grand Marnier is a little interesting.
Yeah.
Makes it kind of a Cadillac bowl of cereal.
Well, Grand Marnier, that's like...
Not where they put in Cadillac margarita.
Cognac and orange bitters. Yeah. So it's like citrusy. It's like got that, like that. It's got that burn that the cognac has, you know?
Let's try this gin and fruit loop.
The gin and fruit loop. Hey, my bad. Charlie, look, you forgot. Where are you going with the Dorian Electra? What was your basis off this?
Oh, it was just something I saw this week. I had never heard of them before, and then I saw the video this week.
So, on the terms of this being a meme and shitposting podcast,
okay.
Do me a favor, throw a Edgelord on by Dorian Electra. That's a really good song. I fuck with it. I enjoy it.
Oh, featuring Rebecca Black.
Rebecca Black.
Whoa.
It's not Friday, but Rebecca Black's in this bitch.
I prefer Rebecca Black, My Moment. This is my moment.
Yeah, fuck this part. Like, I don't know. It's like,
that's
I'm an edgelord. Want to edge me? You want to F me? Shit's crazy. It's a banger.
I think obviously we've seen with like Doja Cat and stuff. We're seeing like an era of like shit posters that make music.
Dude, so I feel like that's been like a
DJ
thing.
Smokey,
that's
Baby
been
Goyard,
a thing since like before
Joey.
That. Yeah, like that's like it kind of like it started like with some other people before them.
100 like, Gags.
Oh, yeah. 100 Gags, totally. Yeah.
Yeah, like a lot of that shit is really, really popular. Like that catchy, like trashy, whatever.
Sorry,
gin and Fruit Loops.
This is gin and Fruit Loops. Okay.
This sucks, dude. I'm fucking scared. Honestly, I hate Fruit Loops.
You love gin.
I love gin.
Oh, interesting. I don't actually like gin.
Really?
One time, my friend made me do a shot of gin.
Your friend made you?
He's like, okay, we finished the tequila. We gotta do a shot of gin.
This is. This is fucking insane, dude. This shit's crazy.
Let's get the zoom in on that. There it is.
Flirt.
Oh, boy. Well, I'm proud of you. That's
fucked up.
That was. I will. Ugh. Yeah.
Hold on. I don't know.
I'm gonna have to crack this Diet Mountain Dew.
I hate that, like, I hate anything
Diet Mountain
just
Dew
like,
before or after the gin and fruit.
Definitely after to clear my fucking palate off. Jesus.
I got that liquid death to clear my palate. Liquid death in this relevant coffee, cold brew, Ethiopia coffee. Shouts out that.
Loops.
Gin and Fruit Loops, not worth it.
It's like all the fruit flavors, but like zapped out of it.
With the herbs, with the root bitters. He said, ooh. You definitely took it the best of us. I think.
That's not my favorite right there, but.
That's not my favorite.
Can you pull that up? Roll onto YouTube. Just search that my favorite.
Not my favorite?
That my favorite.
Oh, that my favorite.
Oof, I'm going to be down bad, but all right. Next up, we got Tito's Handmade Vodka. Shouts out my brother. Shouts out Austin, Texas. Shouts out Joe Rogan, Jamie. Fuck, I'm sorry Tito's. For that dig. But, you're still a bitch. Shane Gillis, we chill. Come through. I won't drink a Bud Light with you, but I have a beer. Anyways, we got vodka.
This bud's for you.
You just pour the Tito's on these? Oh,
Tito's, Apple Jacks, and a little bit of Fireball. Two parts of Tito's, one part Fireball, y'all.
I don't see that my favorite.
All right, no, it's that one. That my favorite, reacting to crumble cookie taste test.
You see the shoes? You see the custom cutter they had to buy for the cookie?
That's your favorite? Yeah.
If I had a nephew, I would do that show. I'd also do that shit.
Whatever, we'll move on. I mean, he's just a kid, right? Okay.
Peanut butter kid is brown, bruh. It's peanut butter.
Wow, is that Ryley Tucker? We got someone in the chat asking, is that Ryley Tucker?
Bitch, it might be.
Holy fucking shit. We cannot confirm or deny. Oh, shit.
Fireball there. Going to the Apple Jacks with vodka.
Oh, God.
What's ranking?
Lord.
Okay, while we're doing this, I'll pull up No Need for a Rock.
No need,
for a rock?
You're sorely mistaken. I only need a rock. Oh my god.
This one's a classic.
Cereal alcohol.
Oh, they're in the pod.
Oh, Lord.
Is that Drake? Is that Drake on the podcast? Yeah, we got Drake in here.
We got Drake in the podcast?
Someone just asked if you were Drake.
If I was Drake?
Thanks for chatting Mango Jewel Pod, and be sure to follow.
Look up...
when he kicks the dude.
Crackhead fights Juggalo. There's one out in the orchard or a field or some shit. All right, I'm trying Apple Jacks and fucking a Fireball with vodka. I'm pretty good.
That one works?
Apple
okay.
Apple Jacks with Fireball and vodka.
All right. Then you just punch him straight in the
face. That one's not bad. That one's pretty solid. It's enjoyable.
Apple Jacks, vodka, Fireball.
Charlie?
Please. There it goes. I gotta change the camera over.
I gotta put on a Joey Fiat.
Nah, I feel like we gotta put on one of the crazy videos.
Not Will Mahoney?
We could do that. I mean, we could rock with the Joey. We could pull up, I don't know. I think we should pull up Joey's Instagram first. We should put a Joey song on with his Instagram bio. Or, not his Instagram bio. His,
go open through his Instagram. YouTube, put on Joey Fiat, and then hop on IG and check out his bio.
Yeah, let's rock that.
Okay, so Joey Fiat is who we're looking up. How do you spell that?
Yeah.
Joey with two
Honestly,
Y's.
I lied. I actually play Pfizer Joey. By Joey and Marlon Dubois.
Pfizer. P-F-I-Z-E-R.
Get rid of the Fiat part. That's mad important.
It's not that important.
P-F-I-Z-E-R.
Yeah, they don't want you to look up all their wrongdoings. I mean, mistakes. I mean, accidental on purpose.
That one right there?
I mean, yeah, that one.
Bad things I've done.
All right, banger. I mean, all right, now pop over to the Instagram. Look up JXYY or JXXYY on the Instagram. This is Joey, local meme rapper. Not local.
My local, I mean like East Coast. Like I think he's from like Maryland, Baltimore area.
He lives in Rhode Island, I think.
Rhode Island.
So like not.
If you
want to
scope out the Instagram story, we can do that first. Or
Quahog, Rhode Island.
Tu amigo el que no se mete nada.
Shout out to Cyber. Thanks for coming in, Soul Mukbang.
What up, Cyber?
Birthday DJ, shout out Ira. Ira goes crazy. This guy right here.
He works with the UPS.
CGI.
Clinton Global Initiative.
Yeah.
He's kind of a guy, dude. I'm going to spank this fucking Apple Jacks one more time, and then I'll pour
it. Honestly,
the,
those are pretty good.
The Pendleton Frosted Flakes.
But yeah, if you want to scroll down, like a big portion of his whole thing is looking very handsome, you know?
Yeah.
Like, the deeper you go, a lot of his stuff gets fucking...
Yes. That's the fucking look, though.
Hang on. There's one down there in specific that I'm thinking of. Always get defensive like a linebacker. All right, that one right there on the bottom right.
Bottom right, this guy?
Yeah, that's Joey.
What's that one page that Taylor follows?
Which one?
Something about Harry something.
I don't remember.
Harry Balls?
Harry Ball shitpost.
It's something like that. I don't remember. There's a... Let me look really quick.
Alright, so that's Joey.
Show me the meme.
So there's Joey.
Unusual videos on YouTube. He's a channel. He's a great person.
Wait. What was it?
Unusual videos.
Oh, yeah. Unusual videos.
You fuck with unusual?
I usually watch unusual memes, but yeah, unusual videos.
Yeah, that's the guy with the fucking weird little yellow fucking...
I'm definitely picture. Subscribed, so there we go.
Unusual memes?
Yeah. He's got some good ones. This one's a new one today. So.
Ballet comps.
That's new.
Oh, it's a roommate. Ah!
Fuck yeah.
Charlie, you fuck with monkeys?
Why you laugh so hard, bro?
In what way?
Not like, would you fuck a monkey?
Oh, Cerebral Vortex says Joey's got turf bangs. As in turf bangs, as in trans exclusionary radical feminist. No? Okay.
My bad.
Trans exclusionary radical feminist?
Yeah, so that's a TERF, right? TERF.
And they're so you don't fuck with trans people.
And they always look, they're like always like radlid, like.
Well, what was the second part? Bangs?
Like his hair is like cut like a TERF would have her hair cut.
Oh, so these people have a certain haircut?
Yeah. Well, not always. It's,
all
that's
due respect.
Kind of the joke.
If you gonna be like a hateful person,
it's my buddy.
And then you gonna get your fucking hair to match every other hateful person. Crazy.
That's fucked up.
Let's see. There's a.
That's also crazy.
Turf bangs.
Cultural history.
Farquaad.
Yeah, he's definitely.
Hermione.
He's
Les
definitely.
Les Mis.
Yo,
Les Mis. Les Mis?
I think it's Les Mis.
I think it's Les Mis.
My roommate went and saw Les
Mis. And they
My roommate Elizabeth, God bless her soul, she went and saw Les Mis the other night.
All due respect, my trans ex
Pikachu.
Was not built like Pikachu, but had the same hair.
Okay, no, it's definitely just it's just kind of a joke in like in the more
like the Norwood shit.
It was Norwood. What?
I don't know.
Okay, that's
it's like
yeah.
More hair memes.
Yeah, it's kind of like that. Where it's
like mullets.
They get Pikachu turf bangs.
Like mullets on a football player. American.
You all know that one girl.
Player.
She
NFL
got
player.
Turf bangs, red eyeshadow, black lipstick, new pair of Vans, chip black nail polish, likes code orange. fake woke feminist, or only ever dates white men in shitty emo pants. Nice.
I don't know. Like I've never heard of the shit turf bangs.
You're young. That's fine.
I'm in turf. I'm fucking with serving turf, cut.
What's this one again? What's in here? What's in the cornflakes?
We got Pendleton and Frosted Flakes.
Pendleton and Frosted Flakes.
Is it yummy?
A classic.
You.
Yeah, actually, this is my favorite.
The Applejack's Fireball was not bad.
Applejack's pretty damn good. I thought the fucking Cocoa Pebbles would be a lot better than they were.
That's not bad. You try this one yet?
I will try it. Cerebral Vortex, you got any recommendations?
Sorry for crunching in the mic.
Next up, we got Tequila, Fireball, and Corn Pops. And I'm going to need a fucking minute, bruh.
Yeah. Let me
Life and Scars.
Life and Scars.
Yeah, this one gets a little spicy.
It does.
but
that's not bad.
It's worth the shit. Like,
was
it? You know, I don't give a fuck what your politics is, what your beliefs are. If you fucking putting out a good hustle with your shit posts, I respect that, and I will show my homies.
Yeah.
Life and Scars on Instagram.
No spaces with a Z at the end. Bugged out. No S. Just
my
Life
man
and Scars.
Is wildin', bro.
I think there might be an underscore. He also might be shadow banned. Life and Scars.
Oh, Life and Scars. With a Z.
Yeah. That fool.
I know.
Roll down a little bit.
Oh, this fucking guy.
Yeah,
yeah,
let's get
the
OGs.
We've seen this guy. Yeah,
you've
yeah.
seen him. What's your personal favorite? You fuck with the Silver Surfer or the Kanye West?
Or the Birdbath.
The Birdbath goes crazy.
You know, off the top of my head, I could not say.
You rock it with the Alligator Fuckhouse?
What's this one, right?
That one's pretty mid. You should skip ahead.
Skip ahead?
Nah, like farther down, probably.
How
you gotta
to
get
talk
to like
to emo.
This is Portland relevant. Let's hit the emo goth. The emo goth.
How to talk to emo goth.
Emo
goth
females, all due respect.
Emo and goth bitches. Yeah, emo and goth bitches are pretty much the same. They both think that the
we stand Riley and Drake.
You showed Joey this yet?
Like no.
And the goth bitch love that shit. So now we know how to navigate going forward. It's gonna be hard for you to get with one of these bitches if you don't have some kind of common interest.
Disrespect is crazy.
So here's the game plan. You need to study up on their culture and put that shit in the bag. Then you need to go to a concert or a venue and take a selfie and upload it to a dating site. How much you love that culture. You're going to turn off a lot of other bitches, but fuck them hoes. Particular ones, so you got to stay focused. Once you get her, I want you to know that beneath all the black nails, the black hair, and the makeup and shit, it's just another bitch.
And also, fellas, on that note, Blink 182 will be in the neighborhood in July around the 13th. If you're really trying to go that route.
Speaking on that shit, speaking of shit posting, speaking of fucking Blink 182, recently on my Instagram, I was out at the bars having fun with my friends.
Okay.
Hitting some karaoke. Hit that Blink 182. Shout out, damn it. Excellent song.
Damn.
Bam, bam, bam,
decided bam. To post the Instagram or post to my Instagram story on create mode. Just said, well, I guess this is growing up. ... After I did that song and the amount of fucking people that like just didn't get that shit. Like, I mean, I guess it makes sense. Like, it's fucking, it's whatever. It's just like some note shit, but people just like, so many people either called me or texted me like, are you okay? Like, like, are you doing good? Like, they're like, what do you mean this is growing up? Like, what are you going through? And I'm like, oh, dude, you don't get it? You don't listen to Blink 182? Like, my fucking mom called me. She's like, are you okay?
Damn.
And I'm like,
yeah. Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
I mean, I was just in Vegas last month for TwitchCon. But at the same time, same weekend was the While We Were Young Fest.
Yeah, so, this year?
Yeah. So
I went to the one last year.
Oh, okay. Well, so, yeah, Blink 182, Green Day, obviously, MCR, all those fucking bands. So there was just, like, It was like 20,000 fucking nerds, of which I was one, just walking around.
Yeah.
And then there's like 20,000, well, probably more, just like people my age that look like me wearing like emo tees. Where like this like woman, she's like walks out of the, I was like walking out of a Denny's, and she's like, "Emo is a state of mind." Like,
yeah, dude, I damn, get that. Like, because when I was I went to the first one.
I thought you were trying to be deep. No, I'm not trying to be deep.
Sorry. And like the amount of people that I went there, they're like wearing shirts that just say "Elder Emo," like yeah. all this shit, and like. I don't know, like, I talked to a bunch of people there. I met a bunch of people there at the festival, and they're like, "Are you even old enough to be here?" Like, and I'm like, I don't know, like, I feel like music doesn't really have, like...
Yeah, it's like...
You know, like, music is universal. It's like one of those things where it's just like, it's... Like, music is like one of those things that really connect people. I feel like memes are the same way.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Like, you know, it's just ways, different ways to connect with people. But, like, it was just super, super weird, like...
Just gatekeeping yeah, this yeah. music. I mean, it's...
It was
shout out cool, gatekeeping. I fucking love that.
Gatekeeping?
Shit.
I love Blade. Blade's cool.
Gatekeeping. I just sent you, like, five of them, Charlie.
You sent me five? All right. Yeah, it, like, it's, it feels like... I mean, obviously, like, the music... They say, like, the music you listened to when you were 13, you're going to listen to the rest of your life. It's like, that's what you like now. That, like, defines your taste or whatever.
Yeah.
And I think to a certain point that's true, but I think just like Disney adults and like
dude.
Potterheads and stuff, there's people who just make that their entire yeah. identity, and I'm just like, that doesn't count as a personality.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure, please.
How many Disney adults do you know with an Apple Watch?
That's a really good question.
Disney adults with Apple Watches?
All of them?
Two of them?
I personally don't know.
I feel like every Disney adult I've met owns an Apple Watch.
Interesting. That's
and they all have the same like the background, like the clock, like it's the Mickey Mouse one. It's the fucking Mickey Mouse one.
Mickey Mouse.
Like
all right, so Dave just sent some, so let's get into them. Let's see what's up.
Few of them.
Cum is my favorite breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I love cum.
Cum is my... Yep. There's that one. I'm scared.
That one SpongeBob's could be
undefeated. Octarkon 666. I don't know why the 666, but Octarkon, go to his profile and just.
Elon Musk through. Is a brand.
He contact me for ads. Fuck yeah.
With the Mortal Kombat music.
Oh, hell yeah.
I'll be right back. I'm going to go grab another one of these unbranded, unsponsored Liquid Deaths.
Yeah, no worries. Actually, could you grab me the black one? What's in there?
The black one?
Yeah, I got you.
Thank you. Let's.
Could you grab me?
David, would you like a drink?
I'll take another Polar Seltzer.
We'll watch this monkey. I do fuck with monkeys. Here we go.
You want the strawberry lemonade, the mango lemonade, or the...
I don't know what song it is, orange one. I don't know what song that is, but like anything, even toxically masculine, any of that fucking pop punk.
I don't wanna be. That's Covet by Basement.
Yeah, it's fucking banger. Shouts out Basement. Get on the pod, you fucking pussies. Get up your ass or get on tour. The fuck.
That song is an absolute banger. It's epic. Epic and awesome.
Epic?
Yeah.
I'm scared of liquor.
Epic Sports Bar.
Epic Sports Bar. Shout out Epic Sports Bar. Speaking of Epic, shout out Epic Bangers.
And Silly Boma.
Epic Bangers.
You know who Alex G is?
And Fill My Hole, man.
Alex.
You ever heard of Alex G?
No, I have. I don't think so.
Do me a favor.
Bro, are you just playing...
Roll through on the TikTok.
NBA Youngboy?
What?
It's gonna be me in about 1 to 3 hours.
What? The fire?
He goes to prison because he had to put it on the pod.
I felt it when Chief Keef said, "I think my chopper gay. I pulled him out of the closet." Makes you think, man. I really felt it.
deepfake.
I love the and Tyler and I or Cerebral Vortex in the chat. We talked about this on his his episode. The AI, like Joe Rogan and whoever, usually it's Ben Shapiro. Just some of them are so peak.
Ben Shapiro's like one of my favorite impressions.
Fucking, that shit's insane. Like the amount of, I got for a really long time an absurd amount, like in my like algorithm or whatever. Yeah. Like that's another topic. We'll get on the algorithm later, probably. That shit's wild. Really, but like, my algorithm for like the longest time was literally just like the AI, like Joe Rogan, Donald Trump, Ben Shapiro.
Oh yeah.
Like the fucking like, but it was like that. But they were like dudes that were at hardcore shows, like talking about their like. You're like, dude, you're not even really straight edge, like fucking, like type shit like that, like.
You drink coffee.
Just like, it was weird. It was like, I don't know, fucking insane, so fucking funny.
It's all pretty ridiculous.
You want to see for yourself?
Sure. Why not?
You can go to the beach if you want. But you'll get old.
I doubt it.
Look at how fucking old I am.
I'm not going to get old.
You will get old.
I won't.
You will.
The beach will not make me old.
Okay, man. But don't say I didn't warn you about getting old. Jamie, pull up the chair.
Damn.
He got old.
But using Judeo-Christian logic, we can deduce. And if you go to the beach, that makes you old. You will become old.
That's great.
That's fucking wild.
You will get old. You will need Cialis. You can't call Blue Chew. Blue Chew will not sponsor us, so fuck Blue Chew.
I buy
my Cialis on bulksupplements.com.
Let me just say, if Blue Chew wants to sponsor their
10,000.
Come on.
Blue Chew wants to sponsor you.
We'll do it. If they want to.
If Blue Chew wanted to get fucking sponsorship with the Hard Dick Warriors Association of America, we would consider.
That's true. I mean, I think that would be like
we would consider.
That'd be like a match made in heaven, I feel like, you know. We got the Blue Chew, we got the Cialis, we got the Hard Dick Warriors.
You gotta get you a hat, Charlie.
No, man, I don't like hats.
You want like a work shirt, like the mechanics, like with the collar and like the front pocket?
Sure, yeah.
Embroidered.
Just says Charlie.
HDW number 69. Charlie and Cursa.
That'd be sick.
Hard Dick Warriors.
Yeah.
I just looked at my phone. One of my friends texted me and said, "We all have turf bangs."
Damn.
I mean, I may or may not. I'm wearing a hat right now.
Yeah.
I'm not going to show.
You can't prove that. My hair is just a fucking mess, let's be real.
There's only one bang I know about. That's Bang Energy, 2 for $5 at your local corner store.
They don't sell that shit anymore, bro.
And speaking of Bang.
They don't sell Bang no more?
Dude, the Bang CEO, what a weirdo.
Jesus really? Christ.
Yeah, so his wife was on Say Yes to the Dress.
Really?
Yeah, and he is on that episode, and he's like, "Oh, you're not. I wanted you to cover up the chest area," and it's like very weird and like possessive. He's also like 30 years older than her.
That's insane.
Let's see. Bang CEO, Say Yes to the Dress. Yes.
Oh yeah, it was a Danny Gonzalez video.
Our last but not least, while we catch up with Danny Gonzalez. Corn Pops. Himador Tequila.
Himador.
And Fireball.
And Fireball.
I feel like they got more and more outlandish.
Tell my mother I love her, Kelsey. Like, I love you too.
I don't know. We started with Bailey's and Grand Marnier and rice or Cocoa Krispies.
I don't know, but it tasted really, really good.
Not too bad.
Okay. All right. I think any like the Fireball and what was the other one? It kind of helps like cover the flavor, like the Frosted Flakes kind of.
Got sugar, but like the Fruit Loops, just like the fruit flavor, just immediately dissolved in that gin. That was just gone. I don't think that was a winner. But
that one. Oh.
We'll try
it. It gets worse. Eat it quick.
Oh god.
The longer you chew on that, the worse it gets for sure. Mm-hmm. Listen to day, kids. Stick to milk. Drink your fucking milk. Get your fucking bones and your teeth fucking big and strong and shit. Stay away from that soy shit. Stay away from that oat shit. Fucking just your teeth and your bones fucking super strong.
We are consenting adults.
Eat your fucking sugar and your high fructose bullshit. Like,
we are over the oils. We're consenting adults over the age of 21.
Don't do what we just did with the fucking...
Don't do drugs.
Stick to weed and fucking amphetamines. You'll have a way better time.
I feel like most of the Zoomers are doing that anyway.
The Zoomers? The Gen Z?
The Zoomers.
They're all on Juul pods, man.
Nah, dog. Juul's canceled. Dude, canceled? It's got to the point where it's Juul's. Like...
Sorry, Mango Juul pod in the chat. You are canceled. Did not know.
That's fucked up. Oh, shit. I totally forgot you asked me to grab you this. I brought it over and never handed it to you.
Oh, no worries. Thank you.
About to spank the Bobby real quick.
The Benjamin.
Yeah.
You guys got more.
Take the Benjamin to Blinkerton City. Yeah, fucking. We were talking about Fulcrum earlier. Are we ever going to pull that fool up?
Oh, Fulcrum. Yeah.
Fulcrum.
Well, so you said he was in a car accident. I couldn't find anything about it.
Yeah, so I was lying. I was just trying to like segue into talking about Fulcrum.
Okay, yeah, let's definitely talk about Fulcrum.
Did you hear about the Skibidi Toilet War?
Oh, I've heard about Skibidi Toilets. I did a whole...
Yeah, but the war?
The war between the Skibidi Toilets and the camera head men?
And the camera heads?
Yeah, and the TV heads.
And the TV heads and the Trout Warlord?
Yeah. Well, Trout Warlord is involved in that.
From Ecuador, yeah.
Wait, I had no idea he was related to
this. This isn't Fortnite, man. This is PUBG.
What?
Hey, bring up Fulcrum. I got these strangers faded.
All right. We got Fulcrum. I love me some Fulcrum. I've been watching him for about a year now, I guess.
Really?
Fulcrum.
Are you faded than a hoe? Yodi gang.
Wait, what's this? Is this
THC?
What is good, Yodi family? Damien Luck back with another banger. I am the original Fulcrum.
Full spectrum,
the OG.
Yodi
gang.
And you best believe it, today I'm back with another banger.
Let's go.
This classic Yodi land location. I'm back.
I think, like, early on, I was watching this guy, and like, this guy is just doing what people are not, like, what nobody else is doing. He is smoking or vaping weed in so many places.
People have done that before, though. Like,
yeah.
Nelk started it, I feel like. You know the Nelk boys?
Oh, yeah, Nelk boys.
Like,
yeah.
They started that shit.
Fucking homie will do anything. Steve will do it.
Yeah, Steve will do it, professional alcoholic.
Yeah.
Dude, that fool, oh
yeah,
my
I
god.
I cannot go to the spaghetti factory on 164th.
Really?
No plane, yeah. I cannot go there.
Why?
I am banned for life.
Why?
For lighting up in the motherfucking bar.
You did that?
Yeah, I was on the way out of like a family's fucking like birthday dinner, and I was like, hey, I'm gonna go smoke a cig, and I went up in there and like it was like, yeah, fuck this place, and I'm just hitting my vape at the bar, and the bartender comes out after like 5 minutes, like, what are you doing? And I'm like, oh shit, and then just walk out. I'm just like, hey, get back here. I just walk out and I like pull out a joint and just fucking spark that in like the little foyer they have between like the lobby and the fucking front door, and just somebody open the door and like, what the fuck are you doing? And I'm like, oh, my bad. And I just got about the way real quick and just like went and finished in the parking lot. But I was like,
that's crazy.
I don't ever come here again. We called the cops, they're on the way. I'm like, it's fucking weed. I'm not overdosing in your fucking bathroom. I'm sorry.
Jeez.
The food sucks dick. Also, fuck Gustav's.
Fuck Gustav's.
That was like Gustav's?
Spaghetti factory.
Nah. Both that was an old spaghetti key. Factory.
They didn't get mad at Gustav's, though. They were just like, but like, the cheese is mint. Hey, yo.
He's got the same, that looks like the same pen you got.
I think it is the exact same one. Can I,
yeah,
is this one right here?
Yeah, yeah.
So he had to be in Washington to get that cub in.
Maybe. I don't know. The window looks a little bit more ovular. This one is more round, now that I think about
you're
it.
You're right. Maybe but, like, same brand. But wait, okay, hold on. I was just trying to see if this sign.
Bernardi?
We're now playing GeoGuessr with fucking.
I'll look it up right now. Bernardi, what was that, Zerata?
Damn, this shit tastes better than
Buffalo Exchange.
Damn, this shit tastes better than a hoe.
Try this, bro. This is the full spectrum Super Turk. Or wait, did you try that or this
one? I tried this
yeah,
one.
Yeah, try right. that one. That one's fucking turped out live resin.
Bro, what the hell? That's got a crazy good flavor. And it's not even harsh. I'm not even coughing.
Dude,
still,
this is crazy.
Shout out to the Yoni family. Bernardi's
Cerritos. Uji time dessert. Environmental progress.
You want to take a smack of the Benjamin?
See, but the thing is, like, he is, like, I know he's done stuff now where he's been on some Twitch channels and people are like, oh, he's...
Do you, you fuck with wholesome memes?
Yeah, I like some wholesome memes.
You, you know Gucci Pineapple?
Gooch. Walnut Creek, California is where he's at.
Oh, okay.
Gucci Pineapple, he,
He's like Oakland.
Like, he, hang on. I'll look it up and I'll send it to you right now if you want to pull it up.
Okay, I'll pull up these ones. We brought these ones up.
Chat, send us some of your favorite Rule 34.
we'll just look at it later. We can't look on the stream. I was showing Dave
that's for me
these ones last time.
Trying to goon.
This is like
oh fuck
this,
yeah.
This is like an old people.
Oh yeah, Instagram account. Socks.
Yeah,
remember old time.
Where it's just like it's supposed to be like I think it's supposed to be sincere. Like it's sincerely like. Boomers just posting stuff, but they're like the worst memes and they're perfect. Like my parents had a TV like this. I remember because I was the remote. Like it's so stupid. When we had these socks, who remembers?
I feel like those are just normal socks. Yeah. No, like,
a grocery store in early 1980s, all glass bottles, no plastic inside. Cool.
That's like a legit like just like I don't know, just like boomer memes. Like,
if you get this, you had an awesome childhood. Do you get it? Do you get it, guys?
I mean, it's a spout.
It's because water balloons. See, they fill up the water balloons.
But
and
they would break.
Yeah, they would break.
I ain't follow. I ain't doing.
Back in my day, we didn't wear helmets. We just lie there unconscious until someone came to get us. For like, what the fuck? See, that's what I'm like, I can't tell.
Yo, in my day, I had a unfortunate menstrual accident on my... Toy Story Alien fucking towel. But I used vinegar and baking soda and some chemicals to get it off.
Well, this is the weird thing because they apparently have enough like followers where this is an ad for some cleaning product. Click the link in my bio to get this. So, yeah, I mean, good for them, I guess. Who remembers grilled cheese sandwiches and tomato soup as a kid? And the thing is, like, a lot of people, you know?
I feel like, I mean... I've definitely...
We had cheese zombies in Yakima.
What the fuck is that?
Huh, what?
So they do, like, a sheet of dough, and then they do another sheet of dough, and then on the first sheet of dough, they do, like, five layers of fucking American cheese, like, singles.
Oh, hell yeah.
And they slap the dough on top, and they bake the whole bitch, and then you have this super soft, super fluffy, doughy fucking... Just American cheese
that sounds,
bread.
That sounds delightful,
grilled with
honestly.
Probably, like, fake butter. And that's fucking, wild. Like, tomato... sauce, fucking soup.
My husband's wife bought me this, and I can't take them off. Ordering as we speak. Again,
yo, my husband
like
bought me their wife.
I'm this
I can't
old.
Take her off.
That's the first time I've ever seen that perspective. I've always seen my wife's boyfriend, but I've never seen my husband's wife. That's crazy.
That's a good one.
Like I've seen like the shit where it's like my
that's
wife's boyfriend
girl.
Let me stay up to 12. Or my wife's boyfriend let me stay up till like 11:30 last night
yeah,
and play
yeah.
my games, like type shit like that. Like,
yeah, my wife's boyfriend let me use the Switch. Like, you may be this maybe old, but are you this old?
Bro, I break like 8 Windows 98 on fucking LimeWire, bro.
These are the filters we grew up with. Drawing a Hitler stash on your friend's picture. Great. So yeah, when you say wholesome memes, these aren't really wholesome. They're just like, are you old? But also they're kind of fun. I just
are
can't
you over
find
the
wholesome.
Age of 19?
Dude, fucking...
Indoor 17.
Yeah, here.
Oh, yeah, we got the water pipes right above us.
Somebody was shitting.
Is that what that noise is?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
This thing right here.
Damn. Yeah. But yeah, this fool of Gucci pineapple on TikTok.
Gucci pineapple on TikTok. Oh, yeah, and I got a TikTok guy to bring up, too. So.
Oh, really?
Gucci piss baby on TikTokers.
He's super wholesome. He has one like he just posts stuff. It's not really memes like, but like, it's definitely like internet content. Like whatever. Like he'll walk up to like old people and he'll just give them compliments. and like take a video of like, but like they're like kind of just, I don't know how to explain him. Like he does a lot of other stuff, but
let's just see about that, you know.
Holy fucking shit.
Yeah, I think that his most recent one. Just super wholesome.
Wow.
He's got other ones there.
Jose been ghosting me because I have like a unibrow and shit. Do you like it?
I think it's a unique look. I think it parallels your mustache.
It parallels, okay.
What? Who's that guy? It's a good. You found the town crier, dude.
I'm at our nation's capital. Are you Mitch McConnell?
Income inequality. Thank you, Dodomo Kuhn, for the new follow. 236 followers. Let's go. We're inching towards 240. Please, I'm hoping to get two more by these guests in my podcast right now. I want to bring up this guy too. Speaking of healing and kind of wholesome stuff, I saw this guy the other day, and I can't stop looking at him. The other day, was it this morning? I can't remember. Or yesterday? I can't remember. This is Reverend Dr. Nick Eagle. You might have known him as Reverend Dr. Nick Hawk, but
he changed it.
He upgraded.
My PhD dissertation has been accepted, and I was in need of one more name. The spirit of the hawk will always be very special to me, but he's bowing down with respect to the eagle. Here forward, I'll be Reverend Dr. Nick Eagle. My healing sanctuary will be Eagle Vortex. Next up, I'm flying to a high-tech lab so they can monitor my brainwaves so I can prove to the world that I'm able to enter.
What's that shit?
Actual schizophrenia.
What?
I don't know. Like, it sounds like fucking. Is that fireworks outside or what?
Oh no, it's just chairs moving upstairs.
Oh really?
Yeah.
That's wild.
So yeah, he's a healer. He says he's got the God consciousness.
Yeah.
I levitated last night. I mean, he's so intriguing, right? You can't look
like,
away.
Like, why the jump cut? Like, what rant did you go on that was that bad?
Wake up. I still love you.
I still love you? Why would you stop?
This is fucking wild.
And that's kind of like a thing on TikTok.
You like this, like, kind of motivational shit on TikTok?
Well, I think it's weird. I don't, like, watch it.
Really? Do you want to know the most motivational person on TikTok?
Who's that?
Will Mahoney.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Sam Sulek.
No.
But, like, there's been, like, all kinds of weird, like, motivational content.
Yeah, the second one, I think. Question mark.
139 followers?
Never mind, it's not that one. Just type, or no space, Will Mahoney.
Yeah, there he is, right at the bottom.
Really?
Second one?
That's...
No, it's DJ Boner Pill.
No, that's Boner his Instagram. Boy. His Instagram is DJ Boner Boy.
Oh, it's TikTok?
Let me look it up on mine.
We can go to the Instagram, too, though.
His TikTok is just Will Mahoney... No E at the end. I think that's what you did.
Oh.
So it's WILLMAHONY _.
Smells like Up Dog.
Fan page. Mahoney 1?
No. I don't know why it's not.
Oh, is it this guy? Wahoney?
No. It's literally at Will Mahoney _.
Okay, that's weird. That wouldn't come up.
my goodness.
Shadow ban my life, wish dance, let the cauldron
is
leak.
Is he shadow banned?
Shadow ban for real life.
Try typing in without the at.
I'm gonna try top. Oh, I have to log in to search popular content.
Damn.
What the fuck does that
mean? Hey, shout out my boy Will Mahoney. Shout out Have a Great Day magazine.
Oh yeah, okay. He's yeah, we looked at that. David showed me that last time he was here.
Yeah, you can't view his shit without an account. Some exclusive shit. DJ Boner Boy. I don't know if they got the
Oh, he got the real with ass pizza.
That's it.
Pizza ass. He's a nice pizza.
Go to the Have a Great Day magazine Instagram.
It's in the bio.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
So
the latest upload's crazy.
Go ahead and just like you can.
Oh god.
Putting his fish back into that like button, bro. No fuck.
Fish tacos.
Horny and down bad. Get the hat. Should I get the hat? I'm thinking about getting the hat,
like,
bro.
I feel like you need the hat. Do you guys
wear it at Belma's? Like, who the fuck gonna stop me?
Do you guys find yourself buying a lot of like merch online? I follow a lot of streamers, so I buy a lot of streamer merch. Obviously, right now, rocking the Will Neff. Too stupid to quit line.
Yeah.
I fucking love Will Neff and his shit is always fire.
Honestly, I'm not really on that. I used to do, like, I used to buy a bunch of shit online.
Totally.
And then now, sorry.
Now I trust don't. Buying shit
I don't
online.
Know. Now I just
don't
like.
Dude, I've had good experiences and bad experiences, but yeah.
I never had a bad experience buying online, but I'm just very sus of it.
Yeah. I don't know. The only stuff I've really bought offline semi-recently is stuff off Instagram. And it's either been, like, just, like, some, like, really, like, low-key.
Same from Sheen the whole time.
I love the, like, random Instagram ads for weird stuff. I got some, like, ninja pants from an Instagram ad. And they're, like, really comfortable wearing to bed.
I haven't bought stuff like that. It's either just been like Instagram like skate brands that I've bought off like I bought this one shirt that I found on TikTok actually. It's super super fucking funny. It's Michael Cera, but it's like that the Animorphs books, Animorphing into a Goldfish. And it just says character development.
Nice. Yeah.
It was pretty cool.
Yeah, stuff like that. There was fucking what was? There used to be an account I followed on Instagram. I probably still do. But
the account,
the account.
No, there used to be an account that had some really stupid merch. I did get a sweatshirt for my sister. I forgot what it was, but it was just like, just some funny meme. I was like, oh, my sister will dig this. Like, so awesome story, Charlie. Can't remember shit about it, but whatever. but yeah, I was just. Like, there's, like, I bought merch from, like, three streamers, and it's just, like, the three streamers I watched the most, and they had sick merch, and it's just, like, it's stuff that's, like, unique, and you're not gonna, like, see it just around. Yeah. And if you do, you're like, oh, you watch that guy, too. Okay. I know you.
Yeah.
Like, we see each other.
I don't know. It's, like, weird. I'm, like, that's, like, for my personal, like, thing, like, I'm not really, like, I'm not on the internet like that. Like, I'm, like, more just, like, strictly on, like, the meme set. Like, I kind of, like, don't spend a lot of time, like, on certain, like, creators, like, internet creators, streamers, or anything like that.
Yeah.
Like,
it's
more of a scroll.
Yeah, it's, like, I don't know, is that, like, some Gen Z shit? Like, the Doom Scroll, like.
Well, I think it goes both ways because like there are some millennials who like are attracted to streamers and stick around with streamers because they can listen to it like long form at work. They're like, oh, you know, I can have you on in the background kind of thing.
Well, working from home. I feel like younger like growing up like a big thing like Vine was super super influential to like kids my age.
Totally.
And that was, like, scrolling, like, from video to video.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so the, like, you know, like, and it eventually just kind of developed from that to, like, yeah, like,
musically.
Shit, like, yeah, musically, TikTok, like, all that shit, like, it progressed and kind of just, like, took that same format where it's, like, you scroll from video to video. Because, like, now that I think about it, like, Instagram was kind of like that. But, like, they had, like, you know, like, it was, like, a smooth scroll. Like, you see comments and all that shit, like, whatever. But, like, it was just, like, you would go from each video to video. And now it's, like, that's, like, the whole format with, like, Instagram Reels, like,
yeah.
YouTube Shorts, like, all that shit. It's just video, scroll, another video, scroll, like.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, I just don't think it's, like, a generational thing. I think there are people who grew up with Vine and then Musical.ly and TikTok.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's what they're into. I think
I feel like that's how the media developed. Like, I feel like Vine kind of pioneered that, like...
Oh, totally.
That, like, form of just, like, instant, just, like, all that shit, like...
Clips.
And now it's, like, everyone's kind of adopting that, like, every form of media. Like, even, like, Facebook, all that shit, like, has some form of, like, where it's just your... It's just videos, like...
Dave, I'm going to send this to you just so I can, like, grab it and look at it. But
sure.
No big deal. Yeah, no, it's, that's exactly what I mean. It's like we're all aware of the different silos. Well, maybe not all of the different silos on the internet, but
yeah,
it is definitely like the life, not, I don't want to say like the lifestyle, but it's like, it's what you choose to,
yeah,
to put your time into. And, I mean, Twitch kind of is for gamers, I guess.
Yeah.
Just gamers.
I've never been a big gamer. I was too poor for that shit.
Totally.
I can't like... spell gamer without a
game.
I sent you some bangers though.
Oh, you sent me some back. Okay, cool. We'll get to, yeah, we've got to look at some of the Tony Certainly originals before we X out here. But
the Tony Certainly originals.
Yeah, dude. I mean, Tony Certainly in the studio right now.
With all due respect, you have no idea what it's like being a fucking seagull. Eating shit out the trash, eating shit out the beach, eating fucking...
I have no idea what this guy is, but he's a fucking comedic genius.
The capacity of life is determined by how loud you can squawk, how many fucking hashtags you can make, how quick you can not die by a fucking shot, and how quick you can get that next french fry. You have no fucking clue. With all due respect, please, pipe down.
Oh my god.
That guy's crazy, bro.
So I was at a bar. Insane. Someone had these glasses. My friend saw them. She stole them from me. Yes.
That's absolutely insane.
Oh, God. Damn.
Is he in love?
This guy's page, dude. Go to that guy's page. Mr. Hump.
Mr. Hump official.
I found this guy on, like, a 3 a.m. shitposting bender. I was high as hell. I was, like, dabbed off. I was, like, a gram and a half. Bro, you can scroll through his fucking videos.
You get with that emo girl for the first time with the turf bangs.
With the turf bangs.
Bro, do you not know what POV means? Oh shit.
Bro, do you not know what POV means? I feel like he does. I feel like he 100% does.
You give the quiet.
Charlie, what you know about like OG YouTube shit?
Hit that bottom fucking left, dude. The Mr. Hump X Sigma.
This one?
X Sigma.
Oh wait. Oh, that's right here.
I like watching videos of black men shaking their booty cheeks.
What the fuck?
I didn't know his like kid's over like 14, bro. What the fuck are they putting in the milk?
I don't drink milk. Is that why?
Like, you got fools just humping.
Yeah, that's it. I think like, that, yeah, that's the difference.
But
what kind of OG shit are we talking? Because I mean I've seen some.
Just like
I've been
old
around.
School semi
YouTube MLG edit
semi obscure like shit MIG like some dank
no,
shit.
MLG.
I don't know like I'm just gonna say this because this is like one of my like I remember like OG YouTube from when I was like a little kid like probably like 8 or 9 or I don't even remember I just remember just the video long ass time ago whatever age I was it was just some video just called Muffins.
Oh fuck yeah. Muffins. This is an old ass one. Callahan Muffins. Yeah, this is
yeah.
good.
Callahan Muffins.
That's out.
16 years ago.
This was his older brother.
You seen
this
featuring
before, Nick
David?
Rochefort.
Cunningham Muffins. That's it. Nut. Date nut. Wow, topical.
Is that too soon?
75 years. It's been happening.
Yeah, Charlie, is there asbestos in this his basement?
No, no, no. It's all wood and probably lead paint.
Very recently.
No, nice. I mean, this is all just drywall.
The rest of it, it's all just.
Yeah, should shout out real quick. This is the GFY Studios.
GFY Studios.
And coming up on GFY Studios, we got two new episodes coming out soon.
Don't worry.
The Authentic Only Podcast. Yeah. The serious work we do, I guess.
Serious work.
Serious work, but this is my just for fun podcast.
Gang in this bitch. Shout out Chief Keef.
Seriously. Okay, and then so by this same person, I believe. Let's go. If we go to Liam Kyle Sullivan, I believe they also did Shoes, right? Shoes Forward.
I watched that for the first time last night.
Seriously? Oh my god!
Yeah.
What a classic!
I didn't know this is same eight. Person.
Go ahead and open your present.
They were in the Weezer video.
Yeah.
Condams?
Were they really? Charlie, what do you know about Weezer?
The band?
Yeah.
Rivers Cuomo, the Blue Album.
Did you know I love Weezer?
I did not know.
How about now?
Oh, damn. That's actually sick though. I mean, way to go, shout out.
Yeah, they're pretty cool. Shout
out.
Shout out
to a certain.
Shout out
tattoo artist.
Certain Portland tattoo artist, 1000.needles on Instagram.
Very skilled.
Does some excellent work. It's crazy with it. Done multiple of my tattoos, but this one's probably the coolest one.
Yeah, that's
sick. I heart Weezer. I heart Rivers Cuomo. The guy
hearts
rocks.
Dick.
What's the favorite song? What's your favorite album?
Album is Pinkerton. That one's awesome.
It's really good, yeah.
I don't know my favorite song. That one's a little tough. Probably my favorite song, honestly, has to be
Pork and Beans.
Can't Stop Partying featuring Lil Wayne.
Okay.
He's fucking lying.
Nah, it actually is. If you, it's probably has the greatest hip hop rap bar of all time. In my personal opinion.
I worked with this man for months. It's Island in the Sun.
It's not Island in the Sun. Fun fact, actually, I my high school, like my class, our graduating class, our class song was Island in the Sun by Weezer, and they played
really?
It while we walked at graduation.
Damn.
It's like the opening to like the ceremony. They're like, welcome to class of 2019.
Damn, you were straight up.
He tried to sign up for karaoke for Weezer, and he was like, yo, I want to do El Scorcho, and then they played Island in the Sun.
Did your graduating class have like a song they decided on was like your song?
Dog, my graduating class was like 13 people. I graduated from the alternative school.
Oh, dude, he's going back for the Cocoa, the Cocoa Krispies.
That's crazy.
How big was your graduating class?
Several hundred.
Yeah, you went to a normal school. If I had graduated from the normal school,
probably about 400 to 500.
Yeah, graduating class was like 500 to 600.
Mine was like 440.
I went to Mountain View High School here in Vancouver.
Okay. Yeah, Lake Stevens High School in Lake Stevens, Washington. Go Vikings.
Was it awesome?
Nice.
I mean, you know what? Like, it's always kind of like a meme that like I'm a band geek and stuff. And,
really? What'd you play?
I play drums. Those are my drums out there.
Nice.
So, I think like I felt like I was gonna be bullied, but I kind of had the crowd to like surround me.
Well,
I had
if
like
you're the a drummer. Herd. You're kind of a baller.
There's yeah. that too. I did.
You're epic and badass.
And like the more I look back, I'm like, did I just peak in high school? But I wasn't doing a podcast in high school, so. Definitely not peaking. But anyway, so, but our class song, class of 2009, was Don't Stop Believin' by Journey.
Really?
And it was just like.
They just had so much faith in you guys.
I was on a lot of.
Either that or like maybe y'all were just like really fucked up and they're like, come on, like, you can. Like, don't stop believing.
You can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. But I mostly had a good time in high school.
That's funny. I don't know. It was like. I'm trying to remember. I think the other options, like, we all voted for it. It was, like, between Island in the Sun by Weezer and Celebration by Post Malone and Migos. I think it's right. It's Migos on that song, or is it just Quavo?
I think so.
I think
there's a remix with one of the Migos.
Yeah.
Godlike, I'm sorry. Hi, sorry. Godlike in the chat. He's one of my go-to, my standard chatters, my coming back chatters. So hi, Godlike. Sorry, we have the sound effects disabled right now just during the podcast, but I will remember and we'll run my back. He purchased a – you can use points to play sound effects on my stream, and he did it, but it's not playing. So right. Sorry, Godlike.
Shout out Godlike.
Godlike, do you have any funny videos or memes you want to show us? I got like two more I want to hit. We hit the Reverend Dr. Nick Eagle.
We hit Life and Scars. Who are we missing? Epic Shit Posters of History.
I feel like I brought up a...
Whitest Kids You Know? You seen that
yeah.
one?
Yeah.
Oh, of course, man. Yeah. Okay. Actually, Trevor Moore came into my restaurant when I was working at McMiniman's
really?
2 years before he died.
Rest in peace.
Yeah, RIP, dude. So sad.
I would have shit a break.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, we were all like... just reenacting sketches in the kitchen. It was like an open kitchen. We're just like, he's gonna see us. We're gonna be famous. It's gonna be.
That's sick. You shit. Like the one fucking the one. Sick employee one where he's like at the he's working at the restaurant.
Oh yeah.
And like throws up on the food.
Literally, Justin. I mean, JN.
What?
Literally, Nelson.
Oh, dude, that fool. Yeah, something like that. Same as another fool that I know at a separate restaurant. Almost happened.
That's restaurant cats. We just be going through it.
Yeah.
Shit's crazy, bro.
That's real. Dave, you gonna spank the rest of those Fruit Loops?
No, I'm not saying.
I'm not.
Spank the rest of this at all. I'm gonna leave it out in the alley and see if anyone needs some. Maybe I'll pour them all in the big bowl.
That could be sick.
Well, the same bowl, yeah. But also.
Well, actually, hang on. Like speaking of that, I when I brought up a wholesome memes.
Oh, wholesome memes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Same guy, that dude Will Mahoney. He has one where he talks about. He's like, go to the liquor store, buy a fireball shot, buy one for the homeless guy outside, take it with him.
That is wholesome. I mean, like. Okay. I'm not doing this right now.
Take it with you.
I'll take it with you.
I know you're not home.
But Yeah, no, that's very wholesome. Like, it sucks being homeless. I'm sure, like...
Yeah.
Why not buy him a shot every once in a while?
Exactly. You know, support your local houseless people.
It's true.
You may be down bad. There's always people more down bad than you.
Oddly.
But, I don't know.
Okay, you kept saying Trout Warlord. What's up with the Trout Warlord?
All right. So this is a rough one.
I've already heard about the Trout Warlord. I got to piss real bad.
Yeah, go piss.
Well, hashtag BRB. I'll let you describe this this whole situation.
Yeah, let me find it real quick. So, yeah, basically this guy's like Ecuador. He's... He's a...
Gotta hit this again. Hit this again.
He's a fisher.
You know what this reminds me of? It tastes like Runts. Like candy banana.
Yeah, very banana-y.
So I wanted to bring up... So this guy, his dad was on Iron Chef at some point, I guess. And so what he does is, like, he'll like give his dad like a meal and say like, make this better kind of thing. So I just kind of get on this. Yeah, here we go.
All right, hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. As you know, this series is the most popular series on my channel. Finally, my dad has his own channel. So
let's go.
Be sure to subscribe to that channel. I'm going to still make vlogs, of course, but strictly.
I was the guy who's like, hey, Dad, can you make my fucking Panda Express squad, man?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. He did Panda Express, he did Chipotle. This one's McDonald's. New dot shop, no free ads. Fuck you. Command merch in the chat. You can buy my merch, the Charlominati shirt, the Chill Llama shirt, the Spooky shirt, Teespring.
Hard Dick Warriors merch coming soon.
Yeah. Teespring.com/store/Charlonius. One store. It's Nuggets. He took off all the batter from the Nuggets. I feel like that's the only redeeming part of that. Yeah, it's chicken protein thing. Dave, how would you feel about doing a kitchen or like a cooking podcast, food podcast?
I mean, that'd be easy.
I was thinking like we could get like two induction cooktops down here. We just fuck with stuff.
Talk about food and like cook food.
Yeah, that's kind of my idea.
It'd be easy, I'd be down.
Because I just, like, I was going to, I don't think Joey's interested. I'm like, that'd be cool. But maybe it'd be on if we did it. Just talk about it. And, like, you know, we know all the cooks and shit. Yeah, cooks on all the time. I think it'd be fun.
Yeah, like bring, like, an air fryer.
Oh, yeah, easy.
Air fryer and a couple of induction burners. That's everything.
What is
it?
I just like, I mean, this is truly a thing, and someone brought this up. It's like you got the content bug, you know, and it's like really like as a Twitch streamer, you know, and we were talking about this too, the difference between short form, like, you know, it's a minute, just weird stuff. Like Twitch streamers think of content like in hours. I'm like, okay, this is going to last like 30 minutes. This is going to last 45 minutes. Okay, we can get like 2.5 hours out of this, whatever. And, you want to have like, they say go live for at least 4 hours. I don't really do that. I go around like 3 or something, 3.5. But, now all the time I'm like, what can I do for an hour on camera? Like, what's easy to do? I mean, the podcast, obviously, we have the studio. It's great. But it's just like, it's always going. I'm like,
bye, Eddie. See y'all later.
That was Eddie. We love Eddie.
Shout out to Eddie. Thank you. Yeah. Be on the podcast if you want, really.
I told him, he's like, y'all doing a podcast? And I was like, yeah, come on down. He's like, I was like, say what's up. And I was like, come on, come say what's up.
Do it.
He didn't even say what's up.
Damn. You can say what's up.
Free screen time.
Next time, Mr. Eddie.
And especially if we do a food podcast, yeah.
That'd be crazy.
I feel that. I love that.
I think
have my own induction.
This is kind of a mukbang of sorts.
Yeah, we definitely. This is kind of like the most like.
I mean, it's cursed, but.
I don't know, man. I'm really fucking with this one.
Is everybody at home eating along? Or do you all have your, you all have your booze and cereal mixtures going?
I mean, honestly, like the Bailey's on this one really made it. Like it's like milky. It is like a little like. The alcohol is strong on it, but it's like bye-bye bites.
Who's at home with their salad bowl full of fucking Frosted Flakes Pendleton whiskey?
Really was not rocking with that one, personally, but,
You got a Tanqueray gin and Fruit Loops.
I'm a young man who hates cereal, so...
You got your
and I'm really rocking with this, so that says something.
It's definitely the most breakfast food I've eaten in a while, yeah.
Really?
I mean...
I eat strictly breakfast food most of the time. Like, that's, like, my shit.
I mean...
I do be loving eggs.
Because I get in there at 7, so I'll just grab, like, a protein bar and, like, some almonds.
That's real. I don't know. Sometimes I'll come home. Come home from the bar. You know how it be. Make myself 6 eggs.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
6 eggs and
six
a whole
eggs.
Lot of, whole lot of fucking.
It's got the macros.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Kansas sardines.
Godlike is sending us the content. Hold on.
Sending us content.
Yeah.
Godlike, thank you for tapping in.
Shit, I'm gonna have to pull it up on the other.
They turned turned the lights off out there when I went to go piss. I got real scared. Oh. I had to feel my way for the stairs.
Hold on, I'm gonna have to. I can't. This I got 2 different computers, so. Mask playground canes over the top.
I see 3 currently, or is that just a monitor?
That's just a monitor, so that's displaying what is going on this camera or this laptop.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's a.
I can't even see that one. So. Yeah, that's pretty sick.
This is it. This is what he was sending us.
Fuck yeah!
Hands over the top.
Let's go WWE, motherfucker. Thank you, Godlike.
That's smooth.
Yeah.
You like fighting? You a big fan of fighting?
You know, not really.
You like dramatic shit like this though?
I like some wrestling is fun to watch. Totally, yeah, absolutely. And like I don't know if you are aware of Creator Clash, but
yeah,
it's like
YouTube
people boxing, or they had. The chess boxing tournament last year too, which is kind of the same thing.
Chess boxing, I saw that one. I know a little bit about the Creator Clash.
Yeah.
Haven't seen much of it.
Obviously, there's like a little bit of fucking whatever.
I know it exists.
Yeah, but it's I think it's a cool idea for these people who like want to commit. They're like, okay, in 8 months, 6 months, whatever.
I don't know.
We
I feel
will
like
box.
That's always been a thing though. You know, like.
Oh,
like,
I mean,
fucking like there's like there's always been celebrity boxing, like fucking Vanilla Ice did that shit, like.
No, that's true.
Dog, like, he was selling real estate at like 2 a.m. on public exit.
Yeah, and that, I don't know. Like, it's always been a thing. It's just taken like a different medium. Like, it's like there's more creators now, so it's more of like a, it's, I don't know. Shout out Robbie Van Winkle.
Right, this is the one we want. This is the one I care about. Snooki has been in the WWE now.
Really?
Yeah.
Dog, if you can't find it, look up that clip of Vince McMahon versus Donald Trump.
Oh yeah, of course. And like, look, she's doing back handsprings and shit. That's Snooki from Jersey Shore. She's
that's some nice level.
That's pretty tight.
She's had kids, like. So I saw that a few months ago. I'm like,
you're saying
damn.
Women who have had children can't be athletic?
No, I'm saying it's impressive. Look, pregnancy, like, fuck. Let's be real. It fucks with the female, the woman's body. A birthing person's body, if we may go so woke as to say birthing person. Don't yell at me, Anna Kasparian. Obviously she's got some money. Like, there's always, like, a level of, like, okay, well, that she can afford, a trainer and shit.
I don't know. I've heard some shit. Like, I feel like I found out that show was, like, pretty fabricated. Like, you know how they would, like, in the show they would talk about, like, so I never really watched it, but I've heard from friends who have, like, talked about certain shit in the show. Like, so they lived, like, their house, obviously, and they would be late to work. But the house is connected to the bar that they work at in real life.
Oh.
So it's like if they were showing up to late, like showing up to work late, like in the show.
they were just there.
Yeah.
But I feel like
fabricated. Like,
yeah, I mean, I feel like in the same way that like a reality show is fabricated, WWE is kind of that same way. I think that's why it's perfect, because in the show she's probably just told, like, go make some fucking drama. You don't like her. Just go be Snooki now. It's like, just go slap her and then you will commence to have a wrestling match. Like, it's gonna be sick.
That shit's insane. Like, I don't know. Like, wrestling, WWE, and all that shit. Also, shout out These Fucking Hands. One of my homies' bands. This next Saturday, they're playing a show at Gigantic Brewery.
Nice.
Along with live wrestling.
That's sick.
Yeah, it's sick as fuck. It's
the hardcore scene.
Yeah, they are dope as fuck, hardcore band. Like, but so, like, the whole thing is going to be, like, a hardcore band, then, like, wrestling, another band, another match, and, like, all that shit.
That's sick.
It's going to be tight. I'm excited.
And on that note, anything else you guys would like to shout out, tag, any, your socials, where people...
Shout out Tony, certainly. Tony.certainly on Instagram. If you can't find it, I'm sorry. But if you do find it, we'll be uploading. He will be uploading semi-regularly. So have fun.
Yeah,
that's pretty good. And go listen to Fifth Element by that one fucking weird Russian fucker.
Can we,
what's his name?
I don't know.
Fifth Element guy.
Is this the outro?
Kinda, yeah. Godlike has sent another clip, so we're gonna watch this.
Godlike with the bangers.
Thank you, Godlike, for that. That's a banger.
Fucking.
That is a. How do you guys feel about the word dank to describe memes? You guys enjoy that?
I like dank a little better to describe genitalia, but as far as memes go, I like spicy, based, moist.
See, I'm more epic. Of a fan. I was going to say epic or dank. Those are my two main go-tos for memes.
If you look up a dank meme compilation, though, you're going to get cringe on
you
YouTube.
You think so?
You look up, like, epic shit.
But I feel like the things I enjoy
you're gonna
most
get a great
are cringe.
You look up unusual. You look up...
I just saw this clip today. This is classic Dave Letterman. I mean, this is really just a Dave Letterman. I've been going back to Dave Letterman because I'm old as fuck, and I kind of grew up on him. You know, he was on when I was a kid. And some of his shit is still, like, the reason it's funny isn't because of, like, the inherent joke. It's just, like, stupid shit a lot of the time. And this is a great example where he's just, like, he got this guy called Matt the Hippie. And he just, like, ask him stuff. He's like, is that dank or swag? Okay, skip ahead, Dave. We don't care.
I'm more like today's version. Smoke a lot of weed.
Yeah.
It's hashtag relatable.
Oh, hell yeah. Grateful Dead.
Shout out to all the weed smokers. Shout out those who blaze Kush and spank Reef.
Yeah, I space out all the time. Fridays.
TGI Fridays.
The classic.
Shout out TGI Fridays by the Vancouver Mall. No longer exists.
Oh, rip. But like this kind of shit where he's like, Dave just like, he's like, I'll take you out to lunch. And he's taking this random guy and a full film crew into a TGI Fridays and he's just like fucking around. And like, anyway, that kind of shit. It was just like, how many guys in bunny suits can we get into an H&R Block? Just like, what was the joke there? I don't even know, but it's just.
I mean, I feel like stuff like that kind of, in some way, probably influenced people like Eric Andre.
Oh, totally.
Who, like, Eric Andre kind of just like is on the subway or going into random businesses, completely just like fucking with people. Like,
I mean, shout out. Fucking Filthy Frank, Joji.
Same shit, Frank, yeah. Like all that Godfather stuff. Like, all this shit. I don't know. Like, I feel like there was like a whole weird phase. Not like I don't want to say weird, but like, especially YouTube kind of did that where it was like in like IRL comedy, like people who would try and like do like all those pranks or just like,
oh yeah,
do like crazy shit in public that like. Like, that was, like, a really, really big thing for, like, a really, like, I don't know, and it kind of still is, but, like.
I think it's just evolved.
It's evolved, but, like, the people who originally started doing that have, like, blown up. Like,
yeah, totally. What was the fucking, Supreme Patty, the dude who was, like.
Fuck that guy, dude.
Squeeze lime and lemon.
Yeah, the suicide challenge, the Supreme Patty suicide challenge where he, like, the lime in his eye.
Jesus.
And then, like. Jumps off the pool, like,
yeah,
all that crazy shit. I don't know, like, I never really liked stuff like that. Like, I thought it was, like, I would see it once, and then I'm just like,
it's very like, over the top, yeah.
Well, not just, like, over the top, but, like, I don't know, just, like, kind of lack substance, like,
yeah.
Him and, like, that dude, like, the long neck guy and, like, Gucci Berry and, like, all those, like, people, like, it's, like, they kind of, like, have that one thing that's, like, going for them. And yeah. It's, like.
There's, like, wide neck and long neck and fucking.
I'm not going to lie. Like, their song, the wide neck long song, or wide neck and long neck song, next up, yeah. Pretty fire.
I'm going to pause. I'm going to use the restroom, come back, and we'll just finish this all off. But I'll let you. I trust you guys on my stream.
Sounds good.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, we're definitely not gonna go rogue. All right, now that Charlie's gone, we're still out here.
Yeah, I'll say it. I'll say the fucking thing.
Say the thing.
Yeah. We're gonna listen to the fucking.
A crackhead, he looked like Woody Harrelson. You ain't seen 10 bands in your life, Chet. Reach for my neck, you'll get turned into an example. Y'all gotta stop playing with me, man. I threw diamonds at the strip club.
The fuck is this?
You never seen that?
No.
This is Dracula Flow 3.
Ammo through the eye of a needle.
Is it kind of like Ill Mind 3?
This shit no. Ain't
nothing to me, man.
I'm a dog.
So this is Joji, this is Filthy Frank.
Really?
He wrote this.
Smoking that Whoopi Goldberg South Egyptian Fur Burger Deluxe Mega Million Scratch.
This just sounds like the fucking AI shit these days.
I'm on 12 Vicodins smoking on Scooby-Doo dick. We smoking Sequoia Banshee boogers. We snorting that good Buffalo Soldier Tamarind Jordanian jibbies. They must have amnesia. They forgot that I'm him. That Burberry Backwoods pack hitting that pussy smell. like a Hellcat V8. We're smoking shit in a glass pipe, blowing the
shouts out Joji.
Yeah.
I'm sick in the head.
Recently in Portland.
Broward County Tic Tacs.
Georgetown Geronimos. I'm on them Nashville Nibblers.
Here's you doing it for me,
Slime.
In the bin slime. I'll have to stun on them next time. I don't give a fuck if I go blind. I don't need to see the price tag anyway. I'm
high. How do you feel about memes as music?
Memes as music? I would say I'm mostly positive on it. Again, the only example I can kind of think off the top of my head is like there's a lot of songs that originate from like Twitch memes stuff, especially people I follow and stuff that like people make songs for them that are kind of like memes within that community.
Really?
And
hit or miss.
Hit or miss. That's a great meme song. I'm Build Differently, or I'm Build Differently. Have you seen that one?
I don't think so.
I'll pull that one up, but tell me what you're thinking too.
The song is called "Meme" by Joey. I'm pretty sure it may or may not be featuring Marlon Dubois.
So this is "Built Differently" by Pokelalz. You like he makes these on stream.
Really?
Built differently. I'm built differently. I'm built differently. Progress. Peepos, yeah.
Like, he makes the animation on stream or the song or both?
Just the song. A community member made this animation for him. In Twitch meme culture, the Pepe Frog, it represents the chatters. Like, we're all Pepe, like Peepos. We're all okay. like watching it. Anyway.
That makes sense. One of my...
Those who just met me.
Apparently, like, one of my friends, or, like, so, like, my roommate's this guy in their band, is friends with this guy who is, like, a pretty big Twitch streamer, and, he does, like, beatboxing. I don't remember his name, but, like, he does, like, beatboxing and, like, runs it through, like, different filters and stuff, and T-Pain found him through a stream.
Oh yeah, no T-Pain does a lot of those music streams. So, it's so cool.
T-Pain found him on a stream and then brought him on tour with him.
That's sick. Yeah.
So it's like, I don't know this guy, but like, one of his best friends is like this guy that like is in my roommate's band.
That's wild.
I don't know. Like, I don't know anything about like all that Twitch stuff. So like, anything that like I hear about it is like absolutely crazy. Like, I feel like I'm pretty removed from the internet. Like. Like, that side of the internet, at least. Like, I'm not, like... I don't know. Like...
It is... Again, it is very weird. And, like, my Cerebral Vortex, my buddy Tyler in the chat, we had this whole conversation on his episode where it's, like, it's so weird to explain it to someone, too. They're, like, wait, you just watch this guy, and he's, like, playing games? And it's just, like, it's so much easier to say, oh, it's a podcast, you know? At work, I'll just have my headphones, and I'm, like, oh, I'm listening to the news. Because I watch this guy, he does like political news coverage and stuff like that. So I'm just like, oh yeah, I'm just listening to the news. And they're like, oh okay. But if I explain, no, he's a Twitch streamer, and he's actually also playing World of Warcraft and doing politics. But don't worry about it. Like,
that's insane, huh?
Yeah. Anyway, God, like, yeah.
Severely beast.
So anyway, this is that's Pokelalz, and he's done a couple.
Pokelalz.
This is. Seer 65. How does that go? This is one of my favorite streamers, and I've actually met this guy twice. 55 Hoes. So he did this like in a Grand Theft Auto RP server, and he just kind of like freestyled this, and then again one of his community members like put the song over it. This is a fucking jam where it's like.
Was somebody played the beat in the RP or like?
Yeah, it was just kind of like it was just.
See, that's another thing is like I never got into like
55 hoes on my dick, and you know this shit is lit.
I never really got into like that side of gaming because like I don't know like I didn't have access to like a lot of like stuff like that as a kid. Like I wasn't in like chat rooms, wasn't like in like. The I didn't play like Call of Duty like on like online all the time. Like it was always offline because I couldn't afford to play that shit. So it's like I was so removed from the internet.
Yeah, yeah. It's like it was. It took. It was essentially COVID. You know, that's and so many people joined in, during COVID, but like. That's when my like I knew about Twitch in like 2019. I kind of had like a vague idea. My friend kind of started streaming like a little bit, but it was again Cerebral Vortex who was like, "Oh, you got to check this guy out because it's not gaming. Like he does play games, but it's not about that. It's just like listen to this." And it was like, "Whoa!" And it was and like when you're just bored and there's nothing to do, I'm just like sitting there and I could listen to it for hours. This guy streams 8 hours a day, so you can like devote the time. And I'm just like, well, fuck, I'm not doing anything. I'm just like playing video games, watching this guy. And that's what I was like, well, I could stream too. Like, I want to do that.
That's sick. I mean, for me, it's hard. The right thing. With like that shit,
you did the right thing. You're killing it.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
I mean, I just just met you today, but I mean, I feel like you got like a pretty good thing going. Like, it's pretty solid setup and whatnot. Like,
I appreciate it. I mean, this is just the studio setup too. I've got the gaming PC at home, and I.
For sure.
We play some Fortnite. We play some...
What's your go-to game?
That's kind of hard. I really like games that are easy to, like, pick up and put down. I don't like... I'll play, like, RPGs and stuff. I played Cyberpunk, Starfield. Super Mario RPG?
I just started replaying Fallout 3 today. Oh, dude. Like, this morning. Classic. Like, I haven't played it since, like, I was in middle school. Early high school.
Yeah, I started playing Fallout 4.
I want to play New Vegas again.
Fuck Fallout 4, dude. That shit sucks.
But I was playing Starfield and it was like really feeling like
this. My roommate was playing it. Fallout, really liked it.
The Fallout Skyrim vibes, like, really there. Except start in space. It's like it's pretty sick.
It seems cool. I might have to pick it up because I mean I have it in my house.
But I'm a variety gamer. Like I don't specify on anything, but. I like racing games and stuff like that. I'm not good.
Speaking of that, I totally forgot. On the terms of like memes and music, Fulcrum makes music. Did you know that?
I don't think I knew that.
Let me see if I can. I think I'm. I don't know. You could honestly just pull up any song by Fulcrum.
Damien Luck. Does he have? Is it just on here on his normal channel?
I don't know if it's on his YouTube. I listen to it on Apple Music.
Oh.
But...
Three more links. Let's see. SoundCloud. There we go.
It might be on SoundCloud.
You gotta have your shit on SoundCloud. I've got stuff on SoundCloud.
Yeah, Fulcrum.
Yodi World. Let's go. Jammy. Let's get some command dance in the chat. All right, that's cool.
Charlie, you know about Plugin B?
Plugin B?
Yeah, no. PLUGGNB. Plugin B.
Where at? On what?
Nah, this is that's the genre.
Oh.
Of that music.
Oh, that.
It's like that's like Plugin B, like those beats, like the like kind of like those are called plug beats, like.
Okay. Yeah.
Like kind of like.
Yeah. Got it. Okay. You guys know about pig punk?
No.
My friend showed me. That's another genre. It's just like, it's like punk, but it's like super fast, but it sounds like it's being all played on like toy keyboards or some shit. It's wild.
That's insane. I was fucking around making AI art with one of my friends last night.
Oh, dude. Dave and I did that too last time we were here. It's great.
Dave's the one who put me on to the creating AI art, honestly, but we were we were looking at like it was on Discord. It was like a community tab where you could see stuff that other people were making, and like one of the tags that someone used to like describe something like that they were making was McDonald punk. So we made McDonald's punk Drake.
Here's what Dave and I were working on last time. We were trying to get a man shark who was surfing on the sand, but we could not quite get there, unfortunately. And then we got Space Whale, of course.
LimeWire.
So LimeWire now bought this AI model called Blue Willow, which is pretty good, very, very strong. So
do you have to pay for it?
No, they give you free ones, like a certain amount per month.
If you pay for it, is it better?
Probably where they have like the newer models or whatever. But this is still pretty good. We're allowed to use V4, but yeah, it says you've got like Dolly, Stable Diffusion, up to a certain level.
We looked up McDonald's Punk Drake and this.
Okay.
The 93 Cadillac.
Then we did a few where it was like Drake eating spaghetti off the ground. Or just Drake eating big spaghetti or big SpaghettiOs. Like, these ones are pretty crazy. I don't know if you guys can see this shit, but Drake. Shout out Drake.
So, like I was saying last time with Dave, what you got to do, you got to put in like cinematic, ultra realistic. And then you go to like Zeiss lens. And then we'll try it.
Yeah. On the one that we were looking at, you could make it be filtered, but like you could make the AI do it in the style of a certain photographer and on a certain lens. Yeah. That is crazy. See, that's like Drake eats big spaghetti.
Oh, it does look a lot more Drakey.
Yeah, that one's pretty good.
That is a big spaghetti with a weird ass fork.
Can you do fuck. This is just the thing now. We're gonna hop into the making AI art section.
Wait, hold on. Let's
I don't know how much longer I can be out, fellas.
Yeah. Let's yeah.
I gotta work in the morning.
Me too, for sure. And Leibovitz, or any Leibovitz, but whatever. They'll figure it out. Unless Annie Leibovitz just like shows up in the fucking picture.
The one that we were playing around with last night, every Drake photo for some reason, like it would have like it would incorporate birds. Like every single thing that had to do with Drake, it would just like there'd just be birds in it. It was really, really weird.
So what's going on? Is that shoelaces in the background, but it looks like spaghetti? And then there's some baked beans here. And he's holding the spig. He's got the fork. Anyway.
The fork's all fucked.
Anyway. Okay, well, I want to thank
you. AI's not here yet. AI is not here yet.
I want to thank you both so much. Dave, thank you for coming back on, and I hope you will continue to be on.
I'm always down.
And Ryley, thank you for coming on, showing
us. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, and please, we'll happy to have you back on as well.
Yeah.
Guys, thank you for watching the stream. If you're watching the stream, everybody wave up to that camera. Hi, bye. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next one. Thank you, Godlike. Thank you for the follow, whoever followed. I forgot.